I love me a good troll post as much as the next person, but honestly, I'm not entirely sure what this is. There's been a lot of talk going around about something called Free95. This is the Pharonix article. Free95 0.2 alpha released as open source Windows compatible OS. When we're talking about anything that tries to re-implement Windows, re-implement Windows APIs, there are two things that immediately come to mind. The first one being Wine for running Windows applications on Linux. This is the basis for what we know as Proton. The other project you think of is ReactOS. This is an attempt at re-implementing the Windows operating system. But what's very important to remember is neither of these are new projects. Both of them are over 25 years old, with Wine being over 30 years old. It has taken a lot of time to get where we are today. With that in mind, when something comes along making a claim like it's an open source Windows compatible operating system and it didn't exist as of a couple of weeks ago, you know, that's gonna set off some red flags and it might not pass the initial sniff test. That doesn't mean at some point in the future this isn't going to be what it is claiming to be, but right now, it's getting a lot of hype built up around it for something where it's not entirely clear why. And it seems like the only outlet that had any questions whatsoever was the Register. Free95 claims to be a GPL3 Windows clone, but it's giving vaporware vibes. Don't believe the hype. The developer of Free95 says it'll be a free Windows 95 compatible operating system, but we suspect an elaborate prank, at best, maybe an unknowing one. As I said, we'll see how this goes as the project evolves, but let's talk about why this is a claim being made by the Register and why I'm also a little bit skeptical of what the project is doing. The project description of Versoft's Free95 says that Free95 is an open source Windows compatible operating system. Well, not yet, it's not. It appears to be barely even a sketch of a demo. I don't like the idea that it's claiming to already be this, when this is so very early on. It's years, decades away from actually being a Windows compatible operating system. This was first announced over on Reddit, which by itself isn't that crazy of a thing to do. A lot of big projects do get announced here. I built an operating system to be compatible with Windows. Currently, it can run basic Windows Win32 GUI applications and console applications. I might do DirectX stuff and make some games run, or what about Doom? It's still in development, of course, and I'll appreciate anyone who'd like to contribute, but if you can't, at least leave a star on the repo. It makes me happy. And Reddit being Reddit, even though this is r/osdev, which you might expect, you know, put some thought into things, most of the comments are like, oh my god, this is incredible, except this guy, who's like, lawsuit on the way. Most of the comments here are just like, this is incredible, this is amazing. Some of the comments are like, hey, why don't you just do ReactOS, which reasonable thing to bring up. Even with this being such a very early project, it's still got coverage from places like Adafruit and Hackaday without much acknowledgement of this being, you know, an early project and really a hobby project. Now, thankfully some of the comments here at least notice that, like, yeah, this is a hobby project. Why is this being portrayed as like a serious effort in its current state? One of the complaints I don't agree with the Register on is regarding the license. They said the project doesn't even have a license yet. There's a copy of GNU GPL v3 in the root directory of the source code, but it's not referenced anywhere else by the project. So right here we have the license, and that's the only place the license exists. Now, I disagree with the Register entirely here, because this is how most projects have the license on their project. They don't reference it in every single file. Now, technically, you probably should do that, but very few open source projects actually do so. We confess that we're a little surprised by how well the project is being received. in terms of uncritical news stories, positive comments, and people expressing their hope that they might be able to run Windows apps on a different operating system. After all, you can already do that, and have been able to do so for years, with Wine. And Wine is pretty good at handling these old applications. It's one of the things that Wine is actually really good at. And ReactOS is still not in an incredible state, but it's far further along than what this project is. And it's kind of like people just forgot ReactOS existed entirely. We find it all the more surprising since there is not a lot to see except two low-quality screenshots and a relatively small amount of code. Correction, it is three screenshots. One of them is a singular color, but it's three screenshots, and two of them are basically the exact same thing with this additional window being visible. But the screenshots here aren't demonstrating anything actually running. Now, I want to be clear, there is actual code here. Code exists. Go here. Go here. Okay, there we go. Okay, maybe, where's the C code? Here we go. Here's some header files. Like, there's actually stuff that exists here. And there is actually an ISO that does exist. And you can run it in QEMU. So it's not like it's entirely vaporware. Like, there's clearly a thing being worked on. It's just being marketed in the worst possible way. Like, this is a screenshot that you could fabricate in about 2 minutes using any image editing tool. This one, this is the paint bucket tool. And my point is that most people aren't actually going and testing the ISO and seeing what it's actually currently capable of. Here's something fun. We have something known as the remarks.txt. Now, a lot of people are making a big deal about this. Oh my god, look what he said. So mean, oh my god. This is what you'd normally see in projects that are proprietary, especially if you go back long enough. And this is what you'd see from projects if you go back to the early 2000s that are open source. These are people just having fun, and people are suddenly taking note of the project that is clearly just a hobby. A great example of that is the inclusion of files that shouldn't have been included in the repo. This has since been removed, but there was a file, dllme.txt. All it said is this file has been downloaded from www.dllme.txt. .com. What does that domain, you might ask? Well, the site is down right now, but this is it. Download DLL files. Update, fix, and restore missing or corrupt DLL files for free. Now, DLL files shouldn't be getting committed to the repo anyway. They should be getting built in your build system. So, I guess you could include them, and sometimes they are, but it's not a good approach to have. And the far more amusing files, which have also been removed, malware.c and malware.h, which say, hacked your PC, get wrecked. If it wasn't clear, this was like a fun hobby project. That should pretty much answer that question. These files were removed with this PR. Remove dangerous malware. For the safety of our users, I fixed the virus by removing it. Scary stuff having malware laying around. That's quite funny. I'll merge it anyway. Again, this is a fun little shitpost hobby project where it got a bunch of mainstream FOSS attention for some reason. Now, this repo's been posted around, and some people did notice some oddities. Over on Hacker News, sorry, this is going to be more impolite than most Hacker News comments. Hacker News comments are polite? What world do you live in? But this person doesn't know what they're doing. Write file returns hard-coded true. NT read file returns a character pointer. NT write file does a string compare if the file name is con, and the entire functionality is string copy otherwise. This is not what a replacement Windows kernel looks like. And probably because the site is full of boomers, People over on Slashdot also had some thoughts about it. It runs only a DOSBox and Notepad, but the developer Pinky promises to keep up the work, and that by itself is already... I hit the spacebar. Already pretty impressive, right? Like, this isn't vaporware. There is something here. But it's a hobby. Why is everyone treating this as, like, the next coming of Wine or next coming of ReactOS? With all due respect to anyone's efforts, this is as far removed from being a new Windows open source compatible operating system as a firecracker taped to a wooden stick is from a Falcon 9. I do agree with the register here that it's not like the project is doomed to fail and nothing's gonna come out of this. What we are questioning is whether Free95 is in fact an attempt to write an OS at all. We suspect that it started out as a joke, maybe the sort of thing that we gather is now called vibe coding. I disagree with that. I don't think that's what this is. There's nothing in the code that I've looked at that gives me any indications of that. Now, it could be vibe coded and then edited by hand, but I don't like the idea of just, like, accusing people of using AI with absolutely no evidence of the fact. It has just surprised us how many people seem to be unquestionably accepting this without stopping to ask if it's real or if it's been done before or indeed asking much at all. Let's end off with this Slashdot commenter. Out of the 400 plus functions listed by Microsoft for WinUser.h, he has two implemented, fillRectangle, ptInRectangle. It is a little premature to be discussing releases and how lightweight this implementation is. Yeah, this is another thing. There's been discussions of this being a lightweight implementation compared to something like ReactOS. Like, yes, it would be lightweight if you don't have any of the functionality. Correct. The functionality necessarily makes it heavier. I'm certainly going to keep an eye on this project, right? Like, it seems neat. And at some point, if something comes from it, that's cool. But whenever I talk about a project like this, I try to make it clear that this is like an early project. This is a hobby project. But it seems like a lot of other people just don't care. And it's like, oh, Windows! Windows open source compatible! And they said it is, so that must mean it's really far along. Man, I there's a reason I don't call myself a journalist. Yeah. Anyway, if you liked the video for some reason, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Silly Bear Pay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and it's free.